Welcome everyone. The latest event is held, and this is the Energy Amplifier event, and this is also a free Diona event. Firstly, we're gonna purchase a Diona on the first day. There you go guys, we got Diona, and that's one of my constellations, which is very lovely. Now the first thing I want to have a look at are the Primogems, and we're gonna speed run those 990 Primogems. The first thing is 90 times 3, 60 times 3, 60 times 4, and 300 Primogems. And let's have a look how we get those. So once you start in this interface and once you start the chain quest, you'll be asking us to investigate different areas. And as you can see over here, once we have investigated in the first act, we have 30 Primogems for each of the locations, which add up to 90 Primogems to be obtained from investigations. Also, a lot of the shards we can use as ruins. And once you have completed that, we'll also be proc'd towards a particular dungeon. And in this dungeon, there's 60 Primogems. And this will be repeated 3 times. And this is where the initial part of the 60 times 3 come from, the 90 and 60 times 3. And this will unlock in different days. So once each of those days unlocked, we can get the first set of Primogems. And the second Primogem actually came from the particular event shop. So once you have acquired enough points in the particular first day, you can buy your Primogems. And you can see over here, I can buy the 5 times 60. I was like, did I count this right for a moment? Yeah, it's 300, right? Yeah, 300. And this is where the 300 comes from. You can speed run the first part of the first day, and you can speed run the 300 Primogems very quickly. I'll show you guys the best way to get the highest points as well. Notice I still have 1,400 after getting Diona, after getting my Primogems. And you might be wondering, where did the last part of the Primogem come from? This came from the final co-op domain, which you can play as single player or as multiplayer, with the Twisted Realm. So once you come to the Twisted Realm after completing your first day of the chain quest, you'll be facing 4 different domains. And within those domains, you can socket your particular ruins for better strength, and depending on the ruins you socket, you'll be much stronger. So for each of the clear for the first day, you'll get 60 Primogems, and there'll be 4 domains first. So what can we look for on the first day when you have the event out is 90 plus 60 plus 60 plus 300 Primogems. And for the next 3 times when the event unlocks, you can speed run the rest of them similar to this way. So once we have this unlocked in 2 days time, this unlocked in 5 days time, and this one in 8 days time, we can get all of those Primogems. So let's go through the event briefly, but firstly, let's have a look at the event shop. So in case you guys haven't had a good time to have a look at the event shop, now that we talk about the Primogems, what are the best items to purchase in the event shop? I'll definitely agree the Crown of Insight is very good because this is a rare one. Most of the major event only gives one of those every time, and you don't get many of those. I believe we only have up to 6, including this event, we only have 6 since the launch of the game. And afterwards, the talent books are not bad. The materials are also good because we can change them with Dust of the Transmutation. Hero experience, the mysticals, and also moras are not bad. So the last thing you want to be aware of is that notice that there are 2 sets of the mora purchase. One costs 20 and one costs 30. This should be the last one you buy because this is costing 50% extra. So what I recommend is if you short on mora, if you short on experience, definitely come for those. After that, pick up the talent books you need and then go for the talent books you may be planning to use later. And finally, come for some of the character ascension materials and also some of the weapon experience. So that'll be the order of purchase. Because this event does not cost any reason, so we don't need to make the value system. We can potentially get everything if you follow our next part of the guide to challenge different difficulties and get the most of the loot. So let's come over to a raid place and let's go through this event together. So coming over to a raid place. The first part of the replay will be about collecting the ruins from different camps, and we want to destroy the mutation stone. Notice different camps and monsters are buffed by different auras, and they're very powerful, and they do quite a bit of damage, and they're very tough. So what I did was, always go for the mutation stone if you can, and once you destroy those, the monsters do become a little easier. They're still very tough because they're very high leveled. And once you defeat all the monsters in the camp and defeat all the everyone that's around, it takes a while because they're quite high leveled and they were taking a lot less damage than I expected. So you can loot the particular fruit that is over here. And by looting the fruit, you'll be gaining the reward for clearing the camp. And this was the example of a harder camp, which gave us the 30 Primogems, the particular currency in-game, and also a purple shard and also a blue shard. Those shards will be used in the particular system, the ruin system, that'll be unlocked if you speak to the NPC after. Now if we come over to this part of the replay, notice that in this particular ruin system, we have the shards over here, we have the sockets over here. there are 1 socket for the purple one, 4 socket for the blue one, and also 6 socket for the green ones. And depending on the ones you socket, you want to pick the one that really suits you. During the recording, I only have 4 of those, but when I have more, I'll decide which has the best one for me. Because I have Zhongli, I'm going for a bit of the Geo Elemental Reactions, and also I'm going for a bit of the bonus damage, which really do work out. Now if we do come back into the game, and I'll show you guys within the game of the Rune system, to go into more details. So, by socketing each of those, notice that we have remaining force, and the force is currently capped at 1000, so maximum force we can have is 1000. If you do not have 1000 force, make sure guys, you do find a friend who is actually showcasing the characters. Over here we have a friend whose name is Minecraft, and I went for the level 90 characters, and I set up 3 of his level 90 characters to make sure we have the maximum cap for the socketing. Because as you socket those runes into the system, you will be spending your force energy, and this energy is quite important. It allows you to socket things. As more days unlock, I do believe the maximum cap will be unlocked a little further. And this will also allow you to kind of think how you want to do this, and you want to balance the slots, you also want to balance the cost of socketing those, because you only have a maximum force remaining. The force is depending on your character's level, your character's level, and also your friend's character's level. Now this also shows what are the buffs you're currently gaining, so you can get a really good summary this way, and notice I'm going for the shielding characters, and everyone's going with the geo reactions. Make sure you focus on a few. If you're going for attack speed, plunge attack, charge attack, you know, physical damage, make sure you focus on a few and build your characters correctly. Because on the next part, this is the most important, because we'll be fighting domains against bosses with different multipliers. So coming over to the next part. Once you have unlocked the act and also cleared the first domain within the act, which give us the first set of Primogems, we can also come over here and start the Twisted Realm. The Twisted Realm will have different reward for attending different amount of the point system, and notice how this goes up to 20,000 points. So if you can get 5,000 points for each of the realm, because there are 4 of them, you'll be set to get all of the points. So our goal is to get at least 5,000 of those points. And what do I mean by the points? Let's come to the realm, let's have a look at this. You might have remembered in some of the previous boss fights events we used to have, the you know the cubes, where we modify the cubes. So they give us 4 different domains, which unlocks on the first day, second day, fifth day, and also eighth day. The first player will give 60 Primogems, and then you will record the highest score you clear. So if you select the difficulty, first thing to be noticed is the multiplier. You start with easy up to expert, and depending on your multipliers, this will dramatically change your score. Notice I select most of those and I still get 1000, because the multiplier is only 1. And if I select expert, it's 5 multiplier, I get 5000. So let's go through 2 of my replays of me testing it on the easiest difficulty and also the hardest difficulty. Now coming over to my replay of me selecting all of those modifiers for the easiest difficulty. What I want to do intentionally is I want to keep it on easy, I want to try all the difficulties, and I want to just try to pass this one for at least 1000 points. So as you can see over here, I selected most of the modifiers, and I went into it by gaining 1000 points for defeating the monsters. The first thing you'll notice with easy difficulty is that the monsters are very low level, they're only level 60. So if you want to get speedrun your Primogems, you start with the easy difficulty, you get the 60 Primogems. Then you start to select the higher difficulty, depending on the ruins you have against the monsters. And notice those monsters are Geo monsters, so you can create some of the Geo shard. So those ruins I'm using are really good. So those monsters are quite easy. Notice I was able to defeat them in very quickly. Notice the timer I had, I defeated them under like a minute. So you know, they're level 60. The leveling advantage is a lot. Now the second part is quite important. If you do want to speedrun and also collect most of the difficulty points, I got my Primogems as you can see. So we're gonna go select difficulty, and now we also collect all those points over here. So once you see over here, we're gonna select the expert difficulty, and depending on your party strength, you can reduce the timer, you can also increase our opponent's HP. But for me, the goal is to have 5000 points. So however you adjust this, make sure you have at least 5000 points. So this way, by clearing all 4 of the domains, you can obtain all the 20,000 points for this event. Because, you know, 5,000 times 4, right? So, notice I see I have 5,000 points, and those are the things I selected. I decide to fight the monsters. And fighting the monsters was a little more challenging, they were a little tankier. But with the ruins I have, and also with my combination of team and parties, I was able to defeat them with a lot of time to spare. I believe I have about 5 minutes to start things off. Yeah, I think I had about 5 minutes. Oh, it was 4 minutes-ish. So I had enough time. Notice that eventually it took me about half of the time. So by the time I finished, I still have 3 minutes left. That means I could push for higher points. But I wanted to make the recording for you guys to make the guide. So the goal to defeat this one is try a simple one to just get your 60 Primogems to speedrun that. And afterwards, try one that can give you at least 5,000 points. So this way, we can maximize the return. And notice here we're earning all the currencies we have. And this is why at the start of the video, I had so many currencies to buy Diona to get all the Primogems. And I think this will summarize for most part of the event. And this event is going to be very similar for the rest of the few days. Because the only difference that will come is the unlocking of different ruins. I know, there were some really interesting ruins. So make sure you guys do all the acts because you get different ruins. Within the act, there's also 3 of the parts. Each time you investigate, it's 30 Primogems too. And with the domains, each time they unlock, you make sure you do those. Because, you know, they unlock at the same days of the ruins. So make sure you compare the monsters in the ruins, compare the monsters in the domains, because these are the geo ones. So my geo particular buffs are really good against them, because they also give the geo elemental shard. And then the next monsters, depending on the monsters, you want to adjust your ruins accordingly. And twist things around, try your ruins, you can also play in co-op. So let me know how you guys go, and how do you find this event? Looking pretty good. And let's get all the Primogems. Looking lovely, right? Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you subscribe and also turn the little bell on for the latest news. I'll be looking towards to make more builds, guides, tips, and news and event updates for us as we come further into the game. And as always, I wish you guys the best of luck with Genshin and have the most fun in exploring this wonderful world.